Hello everybody, Star here. What is going on? We are playing on CP Indulge right now. It is a fantastic scout map because there are tons of places to just jump all over the place and be a scout and do all the scout type things. We are also using what I believe to be, at the moment, the very best scout loadout. Now, of course, there are tons of different weapons that the scout has available to him. I'm not trashing on any of them at all. Like, the Force of Nature, it is viable. Scout has tons of viable things, but if you were to try and make sort of the top-tier scout with the most effective weapons overall in most situations in each weapon slot, this is what you're going to come up with. The scattergun is never going to be bad. I feel like the scattergun is just like the rocket launcher, where there is never going to be a gun that comes out that is going to trump the rocket launcher. It's just, it is the standard. It feels so comfortable for so many players at this point. There's nothing that's going to come out and just be like, oh yeah, this is straight upgrade to the rocket launcher. And even when there might be, like the cow mangler at first sort of seemed that way, it did over time get nerfed. And the same thing with the scattergun. Maybe for a little while the shortstop would have been better, but that also finally saw a nerf in its reload speed. The scattergun is just simply always going to be reliable. It's got 6 shots, you can stay in the battle for pretty much as long as you want. And the one new thing that really makes this loadout shine in the whole new, this is awesome, is the pocket pistol, which recently came out in the Pyromania update, adding 15 health just for equipping a pistol. You know, the downside is pretty huge. You really, really have to be very scared of pyros, but at the same time, you're gaining health for holding a pistol. This weapon is just amazing. You also don't take fall damage, but that's not even the important part. You gain 15 health for holding a pistol, which is ridiculous. Once again, about things just being reliable always, having extra health is always going to help you, no matter what. There's no reason to not have an extra plus 15 health. The stock pistol is way better than this one, but, I mean, come on, you got more health. And, of course, the third weapon to tie it all together is the atomizer on the melee slot. This weapon is phenomenal. I cannot stress enough how awesome the atomizer is. It is incredible to be able to triple jump, to help you dodge rockets, get around the map quicker. It really has no notable downside. The taking 10 extra damage for doing the triple jump is kind of a big deal sometimes, but it's not like you're going to be spamming triple jumps all over the map for no reason. When it comes down to that perfect moment where you know you need to and you need to jump out of the way of a rocket and you've already used up your 2 jumps, the soldier knows, oh, he's definitely going to land there, I'm going to shoot his feet now. No, you have the triple jump to not only dodge the rocket but get in his face once again and end up killing him. Talking about dying, here's me throwing my life away for the control point. It seemed like something worth dying for at the time. I don't really know what the red team is gaining from having it, but I'm going to assume whoever told me to capture it knows what they're doing. So of course I'm going to risk my life running back here once again to try and capture the last control point, which you already saw me try once. Unfortunately, they sort of back-capped and I was unable to get it, and that's exactly what's going to be happening once again. Blue team captures second, and this whole fight was kind of pointless right as we finally finish off the soldier and get at least an opportunity to have been able to capture it. It's kind of unfortunate, but what are you going to do about it? I don't know. Well, what I'm actually going to do is run back here, I suppose, and capture the second point, because there are some times where I play Team Fortress 2 and I just want to be a complete idiot. I run around panning people or just trying to market guard people, and I'm content with that. But this is one of those times where I am really invested in winning. I want to win, so I'm just going to run right past this demo man, go for the last control point, risk my life all over this again, and there is a moment coming up right here, which is just one of the dumbest moments. There is always something dumb that happens in Team Fortress 2 that you can't quite explain. You're gonna see that I run past a heavy medic demo man to come in here to my safe zone, and a scout just runs past all of them and kills me. How does that happen? How do you let that happen? And more importantly, what inspires a scout to run through a narrow doorway against 3 people to just... why would you do that? There's some times in TF2 where you're just like, you know, I feel safe here. There's no way anyone's gonna be able to kill me because I'm here. No. No, you're always wrong. You're always gonna be wrong. But that's okay, because we actually get in here now. I have some people with me. We're able to capture the point. They're trying to back cap once again, but not quite quick enough this time. And there you go. Peace out, everybody.